Good morning, everybody. Welcome to another edition of Runner's Digest. I'm here with my friend Nick.
Hey, Nick.
Hello. We're on the Metro North train, just left the Tarrytown station a couple stops ago, and we're now in Dobbs Ferry and heading down to Yankee Stadium, where we're going to be doing the Bronx 10-mile race. I have no aspirations as to how slow I will be today, other than the fact that I'll be carrying not one but two GoPro cameras, one in the front and one in the back, for something that you guys, I don't believe, have ever seen before from anyone else having done point of videos. Fingers crossed that I get to use this clip, which means that the film went well. You won't know that for a little bit. But in any event, I'd show you what's looking outside, but this window's a little foggy. I got everything in my bag. My check bag is pretty heavy because of all the equipment. Then I got to change clothes. But other than that, I'm just hoping to have a good time. Looks like the weather's going to hold up. We're looking at temperatures in the mid-60s with some partly sunny skies. I think it'll be perfect running weather, so it's just a question of keeping these cameras on my head the whole time and just maintaining focus on the race itself. So no time to wait. Let's go be great.
Thank you, Jeff. Appreciate it. Good morning, runners. Hope everyone's doing.
Here, this way. I actually use. So you'll see yourself on Runner's Digest. Right, I've never. I used to be pretty super fast, but not anymore.
Yeah.
Good job. Look into it. Look in shy runners. Boogie, 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 boogie.
It'll be better. Thank you.
when, like, I try not to move.
Yeah, Kelly!
Oh,
Take it back. Thank you. Holy crap! That's gotta be a world record. Impossible.
Thank you. Thank you.
Down. Thank you. Oh, yeah. Which is like what we're going on this trip. Yeah, of course. I just wish I called you earlier. I didn't think about it.
Six pack to go. Go, go, go.
Sidewalks.
Water's in the white counter.
Get your water here.
Never walk close to the garbage cans.
Boy, owns this burrow. You know, he owns it the egg.
Interestingly, all this headgear makes me want to concentrate on form, but at the same time, I'm not overthinking my run. I'm thinking about the cameras. That's a good thing. Helps with my ADHD, that's for sure.
Go Achilles! Let's go Achilles! Very good. Bless the go, then from the get-go. Correct and whip. Give your door a slap. Put on the brakes. Correct and whip. Oh. Little bit of a hill.
Ain't nothing to it. Couple hills. This one is one. It's just a hill. Get over it. Whew. Oh shit! Oh my god! The Mr. Alien himself! You are on Runner's Digest in 2 weeks. Rear view and front view.
Oh my god. Oh, I know that guy.
Yeah, I know that crazy guy. The only man to wear two cameras on his head.
That's only one.
It's a new invention. We'll see how it works.
Yeah, how are you feeling?
Well, I don't like this hill, but short of crawling to the finish line, I think I'll make it. How about you? Oh, snap.
And the problem with my leg, so.
Well, as long as it ain't your leg.
Yeah.
That's good.
So, we're gonna do it.
We're gonna do it, man. We're gonna do it. Boogie Down Bronx. This is your hometown.
Yeah.
You gotta do it.
I have to.
You have no choice.
I cannot quit.
I will not permit you to not finish.
You either.
Yeah, well, I'm 58, so it's gravy.
Ah, you throw that car. I can throw that, I'm injured car.
Yeah? I'm throwing the old age card.
I gave it to you.
Great to see you.
Great to see you too.
Absolutely. You doing Staten Island?
No.
I am.
Next one's gonna be the marathon.
All right! Let me know where you are. Let's see if I can hook up with you at some point on a marathon.
I'll let you know.
Okay.
Because I need, the marathon's gonna be the last one.
Yeah.
Plus one.
Okay. Yeah, I think marathon will be my last race for the year.
Okay.
I don't know. Let's see.
Let's see. I have to do Hartford.
I'm doing Hartford too.
No, I said I have to.
Oh,
race yet.
You should do it. Hartford half is great. I'm doing that race too.
I know.
Oh yeah.
Now.
That's right.
Go ahead. I'm gonna take a break.
Okay, go for it, man. Good luck. Love you, man. Got this. One of four hills. Here's the first. Go Forest Park!
It's a good distance.
Yeah.
10 miles is not
I was going to say. That's perfect.
Oh, yeah. That last 3 miles can be brutal.
Six pack down. Force them to go. Hill number two.
Yeah. Oh, boy, I ended up on like the pier or boardwalk, whatever.
Yeah.
Thank you.
go, go, go. Bad throw. It happens. Go, Achilles! Less than four to go!
I thought it was only one to go, they lied to us!
That's what I told the blind guy.
Yeah? Well, for those of you who see Runner's Digest on YouTube, 2 weeks, you got it.
You're running better than Rogers anyway.
That's true. Here comes hill number three. Short, compact strides. You got this, 2381! Thank you. Go Achilles! Somebody's calling me, but I can't answer. I'm still running. Seven. Coming up. Lucky seven, the rest is heaven. Hill number four. I have a feeling there's a few more. I'm rhyming like Simon. Don't shut the door. Okay, that was corny. And I'm feeling extra. Never mind. That one out. Hill number 5. So much for my 4 hill theory. I've done this race many times before. You think by now I would have remembered it. The one good thing about the rolling hills is you're exercising all the muscle groups pretty equally. Some quads, some hammies, no muscle group left out or behind. Okay, big downhill. I'm doing good. Doing good. Okay, so with the two cameras on my head, I've been compared to the Google car, which is kind of funny. I wish you can go as fast as the Google car. Beautiful. This is a hill too.
Deceptive.
Number 6. First air hanky of the day. Not bad. God, please shine your fate. No time to wait. Let's go, be great. 8, 2 to go. Deuce.
It's just a deuce.
Maybe I'll save my energy on 8 to 9, and I'll see what I can do at 9. Hill number 7. I smell something that just became recreationally legal recently. Woohoo! If you could see in this race a man with 2 cameras, that means I saw you too. And if I saw you, that means you're probably on Runner's Digest, my channel on YouTube. Enjoy. That's a shameless plug. Okay, people picking up the pace. I'm gonna save it for the last mile. If I have it. Although I am at 9:20. Not too bad. Oh. This may be the last big hill. Hill number 8 coming up. Bless you. Take it easy. Take it easy. Going slow, uphill. You don't lose so much, honestly. Not at 9 yet, not at 9, but we're getting there. I love it. Thank you. slow down. You move too fast. You got to make the morning last. Thanks for your support. Number 9 and feeling fine, looking forward to my breakfast dime. Woo! Well, let this be an appetizer.
Awesome.
Woo! Watch it. Thank you. One mile to go. No one should sprint for one solid mile in a 10-mile race. But I'm feeling good, so maybe I'll do the last half mile as a sprint. Thank you! Thank you! It's good, I'm only 1,300th mile over on my Garmin. The Garmin 965 Forerunner, or the Forerunner 965 as they call it, is an excellent watch with the AMOLED display and tremendous battery life. You'd be crazy not to get it, even if you're not doing triathlons and you're just doing running road races. Anyway, that's a shameless plug for Garmin. I figured even the score, since I already plugged myself. Okay, 15K means 9.3 miles, 7/10 to go. Thank you. The need for speed. Watch out for the potholes on the downhill. How fast is it going? 8? 7 minutes per mile? I have no clue. 6? Nah. Maybe. Who knows? Still filming. Woo, I gotta go to the bathroom.
All right.
That much is for sure.
Sneaking by. I see that smile on your face. Molly, you're the queen of the rocks today. I was the king of queens yesterday. You're the queen of the rocks today.
Thank you. Thanks for your support.
This is the right ticket. I mean, it really is.
Wrong pipe. Here comes the medal. That man is on fire.
What is it like?
That man is on fire. Thanks for your support. Here we go. That's what it's all about, baby. Well, that and some good health.
I just saw the best runner. He's like carrying his bib in his hand.
Yeah.
No safety bib needed.
This is our finish line at the new Yeah, boy.
I like the shirt this year too, Carl. I mean, a lot of folks are rocking that New Balance Spectrum.
Recuperation bag. What's going on? So many things to talk about on this race. But first of all, I think the cameras held up, with the exception of the last maybe 100 yards. And I was running so fast that the magnets gave up. These industrial, professional grade magnets on the back gave out. I need to contact GoPro and insist that they have a double camera head mount. I think it's about time that they do something like this and not have to depend on third party vendors who create a pretty crappy product. I hate to say. So I use magnet clamps, but not good enough, but it's okay. Now I'm not waiting on this line to get a picture taken. I know how I look like already.
So,
take it for what it's worth. Gotta go and get my shirt and my bag and meet the rest of the team up. A little bacon, egg and cheese, salt, pepper, ketchup on a roll. So I'm gonna go get my bag. Watch out for the apple. That's a good way to sprain your ankle. Anyway, here's
the view.
I'm gonna disconnect this.
There you go. Yes, around this corner. Yes.
Hold on.
Who's going straight to clutch?
All right.
Is it pancakes? Is it cereal? Is it yogurt? Oh, she said everything. I'm mad at that.
Bacon, egg, and cheese.
Bacon, egg, and cheese. That's right. He knows where he's at.
That's it.
That's right.
With salt, pepper, ketchup. And I got a blood test tomorrow. Oh, well. Yankee Stadium. Well, the Yankees didn't do too good this year. It's all right. Only one team can win it all, and it's 30, so once every 30 years, and you're on average. Unless your owner was the Wilpons, then it might take 50 years. Recovery zone for those who cramped. You guys did great, you finished. That's all that matters. All that matters is that you finished. Didn't have my music. The headphones didn't work. I'm gonna have to dump the Tozos and I have to go back to the Bozies or the Jaybirds. More expensive, but it's the stability that you need. Not so much race sound quality. And then left my sunglasses in my check bag, but that's okay. I needed the vitamin D, as you can see how slightly pale I am, which is good for the skin, you know? What's this? Run your way. Have it your way at the Bronx 10 miler. Have it your way. And I suck at singing, don't quit my day job. All right. Maybe we'll see some of the runners here that I know will be towards the end.
I like to leave here early, so I'm not gonna,
I'll look around.
This is a strenuous run.
I will tell you that, well, the Bronx has a lot of hills. Rolling hills are actually good for your body. You're getting, like I mentioned earlier, you're working out your hamstrings and you're working out your quads, your calf muscles, and even burn everything. You just gotta make sure that you are preparing for those leaps and bounds and those peak valleys because of your knees. You know, running on asphalt is never a good thing, obviously, but concrete is worse. Always run on the road if you can, in the opposite direction. Better than running on sidewalk, which is concrete and probably uneven. Good way to face plant if you're not looking down. So, baggage is coming up, and I may be having a little bit of a foot cramp on my left foot, but nothing to worry about. Again, I missed a month of training in August due to back issues, but I've been going to a chiropractor. I never had gone before, but I am a believer. However, it's a balance, right? It's not just chiropractor. You do need your cortisone here and there. You do need your Advil. So it's a combination of everything. Moderation of treatment is just as important as a moderation of diet and sleep. So let's see now. Well, we're gonna hit some shade, which is probably good for my skin. I miss being in New York City. I don't miss living in New York City, but I do miss being in New York City. It's vibrant and full of life. So it's kind of nice where I live. I'm not too far from New York. You know, in the five boroughs, it gives you everything you possibly would want, except for palm trees. And but even beautiful water views. Go to Long Island, you got 100 miles of beaches. So now this is the super long line, as you can see here. Super long line. You know what I just realized? Oh, thank God I still have it here. Well, let me put this back on my back. See if this works. Hold on. Let's see. Yep. And back on here. So now I am moving forward and I'm seeing backwards. Thank God I didn't lose that clip. Lifesaver. And I'm still filming, which is amazing. It's obvious the external battery worked like a champion. Now the question is, could this battery last 4+ hours for New York City Marathon? This battery did not have a recall like the other battery did, but I'm not so sure that in New York City Marathon, which cost me like an extra 40 minutes, if that was a product of the battery as much as it was a product of me being stupid and not pushing in my my USB-C leads.
Oh, you don't got no bag?
Getting my bag. Thank you.
Thank you.
You can see. Thanks for all your help. Thanks for your support. Good luck to your 9+1s. A lot of the people here in baggage are doing their volunteership. It's part of the New York City Marathon program. If you run 9 sanctioned races, plus volunteer in one of them, in a 10th race, then you have automatic entry into the following year's New York City Marathon, provided you have a valid membership. Thank you so much. Thanks.
12601.
13. Oh, here it is.
There you go. Thank you.
All right. Okay. Here we go.
Later, guys.
The heaviest bag is
Thank
probably
you.
Mine. Yeah. You don't have to go to a gym. You could just forklift this. This will give you a good workout.
Like, people bring everything with them.
There you go. Yeah. Thank you, everybody. Okay. Now I'm going to go back to the porta potties and meet up with my runners. Maybe give my girlfriend Lois a call, see how she's doing. I'm hoping she gets some sleep for the two of us. You know, it's a journey when you're coming from another state to do these New York Roadrunner races. I really wish they had an option for those that sign up early to be able to have the bib mailed to them. Only because, you know, it avoids having to get up like at 3:30 or 4 o'clock in the morning in order to get into the city for an 8 o'clock race, for example. Now, I got lucky. I really pushed the needle. I did not wake up till 4:30 in the morning. So, and I caught the 6:17 train from Tarrytown after a 1 hour drive on the Sawmill Parkway. And if you're from New York, you know that the Sawmill Parkway is a pretty crazy drive. It's all twists and turns, which is, I kind of like it. It keeps you active and it forces you to become alert early, which is what you need. You need alert and focus for a race, but it's still really early, you know. That's why for the Staten Island half, living in Connecticut, there's no other way to do it but to actually, you know, stay in a place the night before. And for the New York City Marathon, forget it. I mean, you get the extra hour of sleep because they turn back the clocks always in the first weekend in November, which is now what the New York City Marathon has been for a long time. But you're still waking up really early. And, you know, if you're in the first wave like I am, then, you know, you got a 9:40 start and you basically have to be in your corral at least an hour and a half early before they close the corrals. And on top of that, you got to check your bag like another half hour or so earlier than that. You guys may want to fact check me on that because I don't have it memorized, but it is really early. And then if you're taking the ferry, that's great, but then you also have to take a bus. And normally it's pretty good, but last year was a little messy with that scenario. So I'm actually going to take the bus from Bryant Park on 42nd Street between 5th and 6th this year, and I'm going straight all the way into the entrance. I think that's just the best way to go. And what I was going to say about the New York City Marathon is that one I stay the whole weekend for. I don't even bother to try to come in the night before, or it's just not worth it, you know. You got the expo, in my case, we got the Legends lunch for those that have done 15 or more New York City Marathons. It just makes more sense, you know. And then you can sleep a little bit in, and you have the option of doing that 3 mile race, that shakeout run the day before. So it's really good. Look at this, I don't even have to go to the bathroom. I'm in the zone. I think I could have done this as a half and been just as good. So, but anyway, I'm gonna park my butt right here and wait for some folks. Right here, check my phone, make some phone calls. And that's about it. Talk to you guys later, guys. Bye. You may not think you need it. Trust me, after 10 miles you need it.
Gargling with Gatorade. Gargalade. Which is funny because I had a little marmalade this morning. Oh, I've been rhyming a lot today. That's actually a good sign. If I rhyme, I'm doing good. That means if I rhyme, I come in on time. All right, waiting for some friends here. I guess I might have done better than them, or maybe they're already home. Talk later. Bye.